One of my go-to time wasters is gawking at real estate online. As a city dweller, the most satisfying searches are for sprawling estates in the suburbs. I fantasize about the extra closet space, the open floor plans, and what it would cost to maintain the swimming pool. But the real estate that's on my mind most these days is between my eyebrows and my lash line. The space on my lids is getting crowded out by sagging skin. Unfortunately, my lids can't move to the suburbs, but makeup artist and QVC star Laura Geller showed me some moves to make the most of my space. Hello, NextTribe. I am Cheryl Kramer Kaye, and I am here today with one of my favorite human beings on the planet who also happens to be the greatest makeup artist I know. And I know a lot. Ladies and gentlemen, Laura Geller!
Woo! I'd like to have an audience like clapping.
I can do that.
Can you do that?
I can insert that.
Anyway.
Okay.
Hi, everybody.
So Laura, if you don't already know her, is the star of QVC. She is a makeup artist who truly understands what women need, what women want. She used to have a makeup studio on the Upper East Side, so she has seen all the ladies.
All of them.
All of them. Mm-hmm. And as she would say, P.S. and by the way, she did my makeup for my wedding.
It was special. It was really special.
Yeah, I had a pretty good day too.
And we will have that bond forever.
Forever. All right, so today we're going to discuss something that is starting to trouble me, but I see it in a lot of my friends and colleagues. We are losing room on our eyelids. Yeah. What the hell is going on?
You know, it's funny. I'm doing makeup a long time, well over 30 years. I've got 10 years on my girlfriend, and I will tell you that as a makeup artist, but also living life yourself, allows you to really understand like what everybody's plight is. And I think all of us want to look good, but we don't want to look made up.
No.
And I think our lids start to soften as we get older, just like everything softens. So do your eyes. And if you're not somebody who's signing up anytime soon for an eye job, which, by the way, I'm all for it, I think I've got some great tips for you right now that are going to really help you to see the way you've been doing your eye makeup a lot differently and will simplify the way you do your eye makeup. And I'm here today to talk about making that eye that got softer look more open.
Amazing.
So let's do it.
Let's get cracking. Okay, so what would be the first step?
Yeah, so first step, real quick, are you using eye cream at night?
I am.
Oh, good girl. Find one that allows you to do the whole orbital area. I don't do that during the day. That is my nighttime treatment. During the day, before I start putting eye makeup on, I would like to recommend to you, and if you don't have this, that's fine, I'll give you an alternative. A eye primer. Your lids may show veins. They may look red. They may have that tea stained color.
I get very veiny.
A quick step can be taking an eye primer. This is a waterproof eye primer, and it's a little beige in color, and putting it, I'll just do one eye right now for purposes of time. It's right here, and you do the whole eyelid everywhere. And then my other tip is to take it and put a little bit right under your lashes and under your eyes too, because it's an eye brightener too. So when I come into that inside corner, I get right under the eyes, right under those lashes. So I'm gonna always tell you that it's okay to stop there and put some eye pencil on and some lashes and brows. I will say, Cheryl, to preface this whole quick instruction, three E's: eyebrow, eyeline, and eyelash. Those three, I'm not gonna let you off the hook with. But I like to take a light color and put it everywhere on the lids. This is the way that we highlight and contour. So now what I did was I opened the eye with a light color, and now what I'm going to do is help all of us who really have a problem with the lid sort of coming over the eyebrow bone, coming over the eyelid where you don't see your eyelid as much.
Yep.
So I'll use a warmer brown for Cheryl. And so I'm going to create the sculpting around the eye, where when you first look at it, you go, oops, is that too much? And then you say, nope, it's not too much. We've sculpted that crease, and you might say, you know, that looks awful.
It looks pretty bold.
Right, looks very bold. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take a warmer color, like almost like a terracotta-ish color, and I'm gonna take the edges and I'm gonna soften the edges with a different brush, and so that you don't see where a line begins and ends. Remember, this makeup today, Cheryl, is not about like, oh, that's a pretty color purple or a pretty color pink or even a pretty color brown or beige. This makeup is about how do we get that eye looking more open again?
Yep.
So a bigger brush just to soften. Nothing on this brush, just to soften. Now, what I like to do after I've done that crease, mm-hmm. I like to take a light color and the same color that I used on the whole lid, that French vanilla, and I like to come back on the lid because, Cheryl, you're lucky. Your lids are showing. Talk to me in 10 years, my friend. But a lot of women don't have the opportunity yep. to have that lid show. So now by putting the beige, remember, light brings forward, dark detracts. Mm. So that crease, by darkening it, I'm detracting that skin that's a little fuller. I'm lightening the lid so the lid becomes more air apparent. You can see it here more. And that's really all you're doing with shadows, yes. And now this is what I love. A waterproof eye pencil. It's called Eye Care.
You do.
And I do.
She does.
And I really do. I like when it has a little applicator on the other end mm-hmm. because sometimes we don't have a perfect hand.
I don't know what you mean.
Oh, no, of course not. And that applicator will help for blending out. So I'm just going to do a black line because to me,
ooh,
you may be saying, wait just a minute.
Hold on.
That's harsh. I don't want to look harsh. I'm telling you, if you don't see your lid or if you've gotten softer here, you need a deep color. It could be a dark black brown. It could be a dark charcoal, but it should be dark. I'm going to try to put this on, even though I'm at the oddest angle in the world, but look how good I'm doing.
You're so good.
I'm just able to do it. And even though it may not be perfect, you've got an applicator that you can take and soften the edges. And one thing that I didn't tell everybody was that when I do this makeup, Cheryl, I'm in front of a 10-time makeup mirror. So
10 times magnification.
You may not need 10. You may not need magnification. Oh, God bless you if you don't. But if you want to look good in bright daylight or wherever you arrive to, there is nothing like taking the magnification challenge. Because if you look good in here and you don't see any spots or smudges,
right.
I'm going to tell you something. You'll look good anywhere. Okay. Bottom line.
What's the bottom line?
What's the bottom line? A lot of people will say, oh, I don't like doing it because I don't want to see that sharp line. You're right. People will see that more than they'll see the top, so
right.
I like it to look smokier and softer.
I love a smolder.
So I'm going to my eye kajal.
Oh, I love this.
Yeah.
This pencil?
I've never met a pencil that truly does not move until you're ready to remove it. Okay. So this is like a soft...
Do I look up, down, close eye?
For my sake, look up a little bit. And I'm going right under the lower lashes. Okay. And because the Kajal pencil is a little wider, you're going to get a smokier look automatically. You're not going to get a sharp, precise line. Remember, not definition, not black,
gotcha.
Not dark charcoal. The top is meant for darker colors. The bottom is for softer, lighter colors. The next thing is going to be to curl your lashes. Getting the lashes heightened is what's opening your eyes. So,
FYI. I put on mascara before I came because
yes.
I'm not walking around New York City without anything on.
Yeah.
Mascara is my crutch,
yes.
So I'm already yeah. mascara.
I am going to put a drop on your bottom lashes. Like you said, you already had it on. So I like to add a little bit more. This is our universal brow. It's one color. It works on everybody depending on the pressure you put on of the pencil.
Ah.
So if I press down harder, I'm going to get a deeper color. If I go lighter, like I'm going on Cheryl because she already has really a lot of beautiful hair on her brow.
But mine, I find, I have gaps now.
I see that. Yeah. I see that. And that's the other thing, because you know what happened, Cheryl?
What happened?
The gaps that you have, those hairs that you used to have here,
yeah.
You know what's happening with that, where they go.
They die.
They go on the chin.
Oh, shit.
They end up on your chin.
Uh-huh.
So those hairs you once had now are popping out here. So this is just the one eye that I did on my gorgeous Cheryl, and we will finish the other eye. I will not let her walk out in New York City streets. Half
baked.
Made up. Half baked. That's right. That's right. Half baked, speaking of.
Because
yes.
Laura's products are
baked in Italy.
Baked in Italy.
Yeah. So I think that unless you have any questions, we can go and finish that other eye.
Let's wrap this shit
let's
up.
Let's wrap it up, sister.
Wrap it up. Let's put a bow on it.
Oh, let's go.
If the fox in the bush and the squirrel in the tree be,
why in the world can't you and me be?
Bright-eyed and bushy-tailed, sparkly as we can be. Oh, the heart is happy when the lips are kissing.
Hair gets curly and the eyes just glisten.
Bright-eyed and bushy-tailed, happier than we can be.
Laura Gellin.
Yes, dear.
I am fully, truly bright-eyed and bushy-tailed. I love you.
I love you more.
Thank you.